to recap, I think I left off where I was decorating this coin envelope. So all I did was let the magnets dry, matted this top part. I don't know, I can't remember if I've matted the inside or not, but these I matted the inside, and then I applied the coin envelope to the inside of this pocket. So that half inch gap that was on the coin envelope went inside this pocket here, and of course I just matted all the decorations that we were doing. So here's the completed tag. I can't remember if I did that already. And so that was going, that's going on the inside, and then these are the two pieces that we decided to add to the top of the envelope. So the magnets behind here, and that's it. So sorry about that. There's a journal spot. I hope you guys get that part. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them below and I will try my best to get to them. Oh, finally, I also added stickles to all of my Wild Orchid Craft flowers down here. So it's super, super shiny. So that's that. So I do have a little clock here so I can kind of keep track of it, but I think the camera clock is faster than my clock because I did have a timer on set. But be that as it may, we're moving on to the next page, and I'm going to do a simple page here on the side because I like to do something more flat and then an embellishment, a dimensional embellishment on the opposite page so that it doesn't rub against each other. So this is going to be a just a simple belly band page. So what I have is pattern paper to cover the top of the page. Remember, the page is set at 5 3/4 by 4 3/8. So let me make sure my mat, what I'm telling you is the mat 5 3/4 by, okay, that's the mat size, 5 3/4 by 4 3/8. So that's standard for all of them minus a sliver here or there. So I'm gonna put that base, it's gonna be down there. But first, you, for your belly band, you could use two pieces if you have a cutting machine or some dies that you, that are long enough to fit the length of this page. You could cut out, especially if they nest, that's even better. Cut out two pieces, nest them together, or you can just simply cut out a strip of cardstock and use your punches on both sides of the cardstock. So you can have a belly band with the decorative edge on both sides. So that's what I normally do. But when I was waiting for the videos to download into my computer, I went ahead and started prepping the pages so we can go a little faster. So I've cut this out using my Cameo, and it's a labels punch. So I just nested them together, or nested them. So I'm going to apply them. That's going to go here, and then I'm going to have tuck in some simple photo mats. So what I'm going to do is just layer this on this side, and then I'm going to add some adhesive because I want to fold this, tuck this under a little bit so that I can have more room for my mats. I'm going to fold it back a little bit on this page. So I got sticky tape on it stuck to my hand. So when you make your punch, do a little bit extra so that you can tuck them underneath, just a little bit, so you can tuck these pieces on the back. Okay, so I'm going to just measure that really quick. See, where do I want it? I've lost my spacing here. I want it right there. I just got to even it out. So I'm just going to fold this over and fold this over. Or you can always add like a little tab, but I just resize these to just be a little bit bigger than the mat, and then, you know, I can fold over the extra on the back. So now I'm going to just apply some double-sided tape to these little wings back here. Okay. And then I'm going to take my backing off. Make sure I got this where I want it. I don't know what on heavens happened to my bone folder since we last saw each other. There's no telling, people. There's no telling. Oh, there it is. Alright. So now we have this entire space to fit on this map. And I think, no, that's fine. Yeah. Okay. So for this one, I'm going to apply just a little bit of adhesive, foam adhesive, basic thin pop dot. Some thin foam adhesive on the back here just to give it a little bit of a lift. Just cut a little bit of this off. I don't want it to go all the way to the end because I'm going to cut off some of that end piece down there. Just to add some a bit of a dimension to it. I'm going to cut off the hanging parts off a little bit. Cute. So that's that. And I also have some flowers that I wanted to put on top of here. I'm using, this is the Wild Orchid Crafts purple and white mixed tone bloom set. And the ID number is MKX-113. And I'm using the white bloom here. So all I'm going to do is take that. I'm also using another gardenia. This one's in blue. I'm going to take the green leaf off the back, if I can. Take the green leaf off the back. And actually, I'm going to take the little poppy seed things. Just cut this off. I really just want the gardenia part of it. So I'm just going to take these off. Put this in the trash. Okay, so all I have left is basically the little curly flower, and I'm going to add a brad to the center, and it's one of the Prima brads, Prima Optimus brads. So we'll use, I'll use this one. It has a little flower, turquoise flower on it. So I'm going to thread that through here. And then I'll thread it through the bottom of this one and fold it down. And that's going to go, it's going to go right there. Just a flat embellishment. I've already done it with this pink one here. I'm also going to add this tag. This is a sticker from the Chalkboards Chalk Studio collection. It says, shine on, shine on, shine on. So it's a sticker back. So let me see. I'm going to put that a bit on the dimensional. So I'm going to take the adhesive part off first. And then I will add the rest of the dimension strip that I had left over from that. Put that right in the center. Perfect. And then I'll hot glue these little puppies to the end. Simple and easy. Super cute. I think this is just a tiny bit off, and that's just going to bug me. I'm going to move it down just a little bit. There we go. Alright, also made, have these little journey cards that I'm going to include in there, and then I made the photo mats. So my base of my photo mat is yellow, and it's just like the journaling spot that's on the inside of the envelope. I just made it smaller. So I'm just going to add the Prima Optimus paper to one side, where the you can put a photo mat. And then the other side is just a white piece of cardstock. That's the end of that. Where you could put some journaling on here or another photo. So that's gonna slide right in there, perfect. And then you could use this as a photo mat and journaling as well. And then also this says hello there. So cute, super cute. And let me find, I think I had some, tags here. Maybe we can add a cute little tag. You know, I like to use all my stuff. All right, we're gonna use the Tag Me by the Prima Something Blue right in there. So cute. So all of this is gonna go right on there. Actually, I'll put the tag on this side. Okay. Love it. So let's take that off, and then I'm going to add my adhesive. I'm using my ATG gun and a squirt of glue. A squirt of hot glue. Just a little bit. There we go. And then we'll just add these back. And tag. And there we go. We're done with that page. All right, so now we're on to this page. And I was a little ambitious with this page, but I tried my best to get the pieces ready. Oh, this is all the pieces for this page. So, I'm going to use the washi tape pad on the bottom base here. So, you want to mat this first with whatever pattern paper that you want on here. So, what you want to do is, before you adhere this down, this this sheet of paper down, this is your base. This will be a photo. You will be able to put a photo here. So, you do want a nice color down here, a nice pattern paper. It's not going to be covered. So, but you want to get another cardstock sheet and cut it at, I think this is four. Let me get my, let me see. Okay, this is 11 by 4 1/4 and score it at 5 1/2. I have that written down right there. Okay, so 11 and 4 by 4 1/4. And then score it at 5 1/2. So basically you're just folding a piece of paper in half. And then I added a flange here, a little paper flange, and this is cut at 2 inches wide by 4 1/2, and then I clipped the edges, you guys know. So you want to apply adhesive to the back of one side and apply it to the back, and then apply adhesive here to the top part of the other side, because that's going to go on this paper. You guys see that? So fold it over, add a flange just to one side. So that's the back of the flange. You can see that there. This is the piece here folded. So I'm just going to add some more adhesive. Tuck that down, because that's going to mat right on top of here. Make sure you get it nice and even so that this can fold open and up. That's the plan. Okay, so while that's folded up, we'll go ahead and we'll mat this base that's going to cover that four and that flange. Hold on, this is a little crooked. Drive me nuts. Make sure you get this right on that flange, right on the edge. Okay. And then you want to cover your base And like I said, this is washi tape. And it was a pretty aqua color. So I just decided to use it. Okay, there we go. Hopefully it works out well for me. I sure as heck ran out of blue paper. All right. Let's see here. I am not liking that at all. Let's just get this off. It looks so much better on the white paper. Stick that back on there. Well, I had another mat for another piece of the mini album, but I guess I'll use it here. I was saving it out. Let's see. Oh, you know what? I have a piece here. My golly, Miss Marley. Okay. I'm going to cut this. No. What was that? 5.5. A little bit shorter than 5.5. 5.5 by 4.25. Okay. That's good enough. It's a bigger block than I'd anticipated, but I'm not going to waste any paper. Okay. We're just going to match your envelope as normal, as you would normally, with your normal measurements. So that's gonna go here. Okay, and then I have the rest of the mats. I think this one goes here. Okay, mat the back, flip it up, so that's flipped down, so mat the back. And I've already done my cutting while I was loading the videos. So I'm gonna map the back page, fold that down, and then these two need to be matted. I think these go here and here, and these mats are wrote it down. 4.125 by 5.375. Put that in inside here. This paper is so pretty. Such a pretty blue. And this side here. So we're already, we're not even done with the other parts, but we already have 1, 2, 3, 4 mats. This is not going to be a mat, but lots of room. Nice size mats, okay? So that's that. And then this is my photo mat for the inside. I might as well adhere that while it's right here. You know, all the pages have tag inserts, photo mats. Feel free to stamp these as you like or add something to them. There's room in that pocket for it. So, not very dimensional, but there's some room in there for some stamping or a sticker or something. That's just going to go in there like that. So, now we're on this top part here. And this is what we have planned for that. It's going to be an envelope that's going to open like such and then have a separate opening. And all of my, I've matted all of my, or cut all of my paper. So we'll start from the beginning here so I can give you some measurements. Okay. Okay. This base paper is 11 by 5.5. 11 by 5.5. And on the 11-inch side. You want to score at 3 1/4 and 7 1/2. Okay. That's going to fit right on top of that blank page that we just matted. Exactly on top of that. I'm going to fold that down a bit. I'm going to add adhesive to the back here. And I'm going to add just a little bit extra if I can. So this is going to be a fat part, a fold over, and a smaller one. The smaller one goes at the bottom so that that top overlaps. Okay. So right now we're going to close it and put it on top of this envelope or this page. I can't see it because everything's meshing together. So I'm going to hold it up. Line it up as best you can. All right, so now you should have it like that. That's going to open like such and like that. Building lots of room here. So now we have the photo mats for the top, and I'll do the inside first. Let's just do the inside first. So we have an extra page that's going to fold on the inside. So this is going to go here with a little flap. So you want to cut another piece of pattern paper to 4 1/4 by 5 1/2. And then on the 4 1/4 inch side, score at 1/2 inch. So 4 1/4, 4 1/4, and you want to score at 1/2 inch right there. And then that is 5 1/2. I'll fold that over and then cut the little triangle on the edge, just a little sliver. And then we're gonna so this is what you should have. Here's your little flange down here. Apply adhesive to just the bottom half, the underside of that 1/2 inch piece. So adhesive is down here at the bottom, and then this middle section is where we'll apply this piece of paper right above the score line. Okay, so then you have an extra fold out mat for paper, for photos. So this piece is cut at 5 1/2 by 4 1/4, and it's going to be the photo mat base that's going to go over top of the flange and piece that you just cut to help cover that little flange up and be the background piece for the base. Again, that's 5 1/2 by 4 1/4. Very pretty paper here. Make sure you get it in the middle, covering up everything. So now this needs to be matted. So I have my blue paper to cover my base, and that's cut at 5 1/8 by 3 1/2, both pieces. So you need two of those. One in your plain card stock for your journaling, or if you're doing all pattern paper, you know, it's the same thing. But I'm gonna do some room for journaling with an option of putting a picture there if I want to. So 5 3/8 by 3 1/2. Okay. Put that there. And then now we just have these two photos to mat. So this bottom piece is cut at 5 3/8 by 3 You'll need two of those. One for the inside, and then whatever you choose for your pattern paper for the outside. 5 3/8 by 3. Let me see. Let me see if I want to do another brad closure. I think I will. I think I'm going to close this because I don't know if this is going to stay closed by itself. So, good thing the ATG tape is forgiving enough. So, I have this as my top. I gotta go. I'm just making sure where I can put this at. The brad, the hole, or if it'll look right at all. So, just give me a moment. Un momento. No. That's not gonna look right. So, I'm just gonna make sure I got all my tape on here. I'm gonna map that back, and then we'll map the front. We're matting the front at the bottom. Okay. Make sure I got that right here. So now we just need to map the inside of the top, and this is 5 3/8 by 3 3/8. You'll need two of those. No! I'm out of tape. So we'll have to wet it up really quick until I pause this to go get the tape. Let's see. We'll use Beacon 3-in-1 wet glue. This dries pretty fast too, so I'm okay with using this. 5 3/8 by 3 3/8 was this photo mat. Oh, I don't want to put that upside down here. Hold on. Okay. All right. I like this wet glue. Dries pretty fast. One second. Okay. All right. So, got everything all matted here, and I think I'm just gonna add some Velcro or something down here. I don't know yet. So this is a pattern paper from the collection. It says do what makes you happy, and then I cut these out from my Cameo. This is just using Basil cardstock, but I'm going to layer it to make it a bit thicker and put it on top of here. Do more of what makes you happy, that's what it says. So, I'm going to add some adhesive to this. I don't like, although the Cameo can cut out chipboard, I don't like to mess up my blade. So, I feel more comfortable layering cardstock. And Basil is not a thin, you know, cardstock. It's pretty sturdy, so I'll just layer two of them and I'll be okay. So, let's give that a good crease, and then I'm going to add a little bit around this perimeter because I'm just going to lay it right on top of the sentiment to get it centered. right on top of this little sentiment here. Do more what makes you happy. Love it. Just get that in there really good. Okay. Okay. Now I'm going to use my tiny little scissors and cut around it. You won't see this part at all at the bottom underneath. Just cut underneath. If you're doing this same thing, just cut underneath the blue that doesn't show. That's why I didn't put any glue on that part. Be careful. Okay. Cute. Do more of what makes you happy. So now I'm just going to apply some tape, double-sided tape to the back. All right, this is too big. Cut that up a little bit. Okay. Uh-oh, I just dropped something. I like this little sentiment. It's really cute. Adds a little extra. One more piece here. Okay, so do more of what makes you happy. Right there. Love it. Super cute. Okay, let's move out some of this stuff. And now we have to figure out what I was going to do with this closure. I don't know yet. I don't know. Maybe I can put some twine over here on it. Or I could use Velcro. Let's see how this twine works first. This is readily available. All right. Twine is twisted. That can go right around there. Nobody will see that. And I could actually tie it right there. So, let's see. I will have to tape that up. Ah! I need something. Where's my whole thing? Right, we'll just put it right there. And use another brad. Put that through there. Press it down some. Poor piece of paper. It's just been through a lot. So, this is your last go around, honey. You're going to stay down after this. Because after I put this wet glue up here, there's no coming back. Okay. It's a good thing about being a scrapper, guys. You just kind of pull it up and put another piece down. Nobody knows. And then now we just put that down there. All right. She's done. She's not coming back up. All right. Cute. Now, put the twine around here. just tie this in a knot. And then we'll tie this around here. Here we go. So we have our photo mat on this page, and do more of what makes you happy. You guys can see. And you have a photo mat there and there and there. And then photo mat and journaling here and the base here. So you close all of that up, and then you can open this up this way and then close that back and then open it again that way for another photo mat. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 10 and 11 places just on this alone for a photo or journaling opportunity. Now, where did I put the photo mat for that? Oh, yeah. 11 places. Now, that's some real estate. Lots and lots of real estate. So, all right. So, this is what we have so far. And I am going to add some stickles to these flowers. And we'll be back to do these next two pages. All right. See you next time.